Hey guys, Pat Dude here at Derange. I got my Smith & Wesson FPC and the Kel-Tec S-Sub 2000 Gen 3. So, and this one has the HoloSun 4.3B on there, and this one's got a cheapo mid 10, like, you know, from Amazon. So I'm shooting at 50 yards, and let's go see which one's which. So the right target's gonna be the Kel-Tec and the left target is going to be the Smith & Wesson. So let's see how it does for these two rifles. Rifles are unloaded, clear, mags out and everything. So always have to be safe. All right, let's see how it did. So the next thing I'm going to do, guys, is going to change this red dot for the HoloSuns and put it on the Smiths and vice versa. So, you know, just to be sure that there's no other difference between that. I'm shooting also a boat PMC bronze ammo, so right one, Kel-Tec fresh target. So as you can see, this is the this is the group with the Kel-Tec, and let's compare it to my hand. So yeah, not all that great at 50 yards. And let's look at the Smiths. So this is the Smith & Wesson. So Smith & Wesson Kel-Tec Sub 2000, Smith & Wesson's Kel-Tec Sub 2000, HoloSun 4.3B, cheap Amazon freaking red dot on a Smith & Wesson FPC. So yeah, I think it's pretty clear, right? So you can see that the groups here is like maybe like 2 inch or something, like 2-3 inch, and this one is like 10-20 inches apart. So, and I'm using a bench rest like you saw, like a lead sled, and just putting the dot back in the middle every time and just doing the exact same thing. And you can see like there's no contest, like the Smiths is the winner on this one. Which, you know, I like the Kel-Tec because it uses Glock mags, but if it's not that precise like that, like what's the point? You know, the Kel-Tec is absolute garbage when it comes to precision at range. So it's just ridiculous. It's just ridiculous. So unless it doesn't really like, doesn't like the PMC bronze, which the Kel-Tec eats up anything, like, I mean, not the Kel-Tec, but the Smith & Wesson FPC, it eats up like PMC bronze, Winchester white box, it eats up everything, and it's gonna be the same freaking accuracy. And the Kel-Tec is just all over the place. So Sub 2000 Gen 3, the latest model, and it's just like, you know, you can see that it's bigger than my hand, and I got pretty big hands, so it's like the two furthest apart here, like I gotta stretch my hand, like, man, this crazy. It's crazy to see that much difference between two guns. And yeah, so Kel-Tec is Kel-Tec. So I'm probably gonna resell the Kel-Tec because I don't wanna keep a gun that's not super precise with, you know, just general type plinking ammo. And I like it, but you know, the Kel-Tec has some issue that you gotta slam the barrel back to lock it in. The Smith & Wesson, all you have to do is flip it and it locks in place, like easy. So that's just my two cents. Like the Kel-Tec is, the Smith & Wesson is just better built, and it just has some quirks, like the slide release that is not really functional, in my opinion, maybe on some of your guys' guns. But you know, for me, the most important thing is reliability and the barrel. So Kel-Tec Sub 2000 Gen 3, in the beginning when I first got in, I got a few hiccups. Now it's kind of broken in, and I got like a couple of hundred rounds through. Same thing for the Smiths. But the Smith from the beginning, that's what the performance I was getting, like not cleaning it up, not doing a proper break-in, and just doing the same thing. I think I did a better break-in on the Kel-Tec Sub 2000 Gen 3. So I like that you can rotate the barrel and everything, but I don't know if that's introducing like a variable that's a little bit less precise or something, that's not as locked in, or I don't know what's up with that. But I'm gonna switch sights to see if the red dot doesn't do any difference. So I'm gonna go with the HoloSuns next time on the Kel-Tec, and just the Smith & Wesson, and the cheap Amazon red dot on the Kel-Tec Sub 2000 to see if that makes a difference. Hopefully, you know, it's not the gun, but it looks like it's the gun because I got my iron sights, and I shot iron sights, and the groups are pretty much as big as this. So It's absolutely crazy to see that difference. Alright guys, hope you guys enjoyed this little video. I didn't put any shooting in there because YouTube, you know, I don't want to have my channel strike and demonetize and everything. So I'm just showing you guys the result of Kel-Tec Sub 2000 Gen 3 versus the Smith & Wesson FPC. Let me know what you guys know and think in the comments. If you appreciate that video, give it a thumbs up. That's appreciated. And I'm going to probably do an update video switching optics and just see if that makes a difference or not. But I don't think it will. And I think that's between the two, because I bought the two when they were on sale and they had a pre-sale in Canada for the Sub 2000 Gen 3. I wasn't going to buy it, but I decided to go for it, and I'm just really disappointed in the accuracy so far. So if Kel-Tec want to respond to this video and just say like, eh, return it, we'll exchange it for a new one or something. Although I am in Canada, but I am in a province where you don't need to, you know, have your gun registered. So I don't know if that could work or do anything, or if I can contact the company and saying I'd like to return the rifle because it's absolute garbage, but that I purchased from, and Kel-Tec can maybe refund them or something. So, but yeah, so I'd stay with a mostly reputable brand when it comes to buying rifles. I mean, the Kel-Tec Sub 2000 can be a fun gun, and if you're just shooting for fun and just plink, well, even plinking at some cans or, you know, Coke cans or something like that, you want something that's going to be, because if you're looking at the size of a Coke can, you know, you might not hit it every time. So just saying. So, all right, guys, catch you guys on the next one.